are you sitting?
Right then.
I'll join you one by one.
We've got one. Are we getting one so for each?
Yeah, we got one for each. Yeah.
Is that real?
We all get a chair each.
It's like we're having. This is like psyche time.
I go first. Yeah. Here's is going to take me on.
I'm going to have a quick snooze, lads. I'll see you later.
Okay, go on.
So you've got the comfy sofa there. That's a good one.
I've got my grandma's sofa.
Right, as you can see, everyone watching around the world, this is One Direction as you've never seen them before, split up, lying on couches, about to be grilled in a way they've never been grilled, because I've had the entire world sending me questions for these guys. And to say they're embarrassing is the understatement of the century. So
I bet you're delighted you've got more Twitter followers now.
You love Twitter, don't you, Pete?
Yeah?
You
Twitter.
Do love Twitter.
I like a bit of Twitter. Yeah, I mean, I haven't got quite as many followers as you lot, but at least some of mine are over 15.
Social media is great, isn't it? Isn't social media great?
Yeah. I'll tell you what is great, because for those who don't follow football, my team, Arsenal, are currently top of the league. And none of the teams the boys follow are top of the
West
league.
West Brom will get there, mate.
Let's just have a bit of Guna love.
Come on, Darby.
Right, Liam. Niall, the first question comes from Emily. Why does Niall always smell?
Why does Piers always smell?
It wasn't me that asked the question. It's one of your fans asking the very question that you threw at me last year. She'd like to know why you always stink.
Well, Niall's a big fan of farting, aren't you, Niall?
Yeah, I was a colic child, which means that I can't burp, so everything comes out of the other end.
OK, look, this is a real question. What is the worst thing you've ever done in public?
I was on Jonathan Ross last week, and I asked Jonathan Ross, the famous Jonathan Ross, could I go for a wee on his chat show?
And what was the answer?
You can wait a couple of minutes, which ended up being 15 minutes later. You would have let me go to the toilet, wouldn't you?
I'd have let you go.
Yeah, of course you would.
I'd have let you go. I'll be back to you in a moment. All right. Harry, it's time to come to you. So about one in three of all the questions I've had were very simple. Are you dating Kendall Jenner? Yes or no?
I mean, we went out for dinner, but no, I guess.
Dinner here in Los Angeles, a hot date?
I mean...
Budding romance?
Dunno.
Move on.
Yeah, let's move on, shall we? It's
supposed to be tough questions.
You're
passing, eh? Right, I'm about to.
You sting.
All right, easy, Tiger, you're coming.
I ain't got any other jokes, Piers.
I'll be getting to your love life soon. You can relax.
Okay.
If you could swap bodies with another male celebrity, present company accepted, who would it be?
Definitely not you.
I mean, first choice would be you.
Obviously.
I mean, not so obviously. I'd go...
It's my daughter, and you've made her cry. It's her birthday today, by the way.
I'm sorry. Happy birthday.
She's two today, and you've just made my daughter cry.
I really like your pigtails.
She wants to know the answer to these questions, and you're dithering.
I'll say you, because I think she'll like that.
She would like that. Yeah. So you would, just to clarify, you would choose my body.
It's the chiselled abs.
It's body. Listen, mate. Right, let's go down to Zane. OK, now, you've had a rather interesting tattoo. You've been in Los Angeles, it's caused a bit of controversy. Can we see it?
It's in a bit of a private area.
It's here, isn't it?
It's a bit low down to be showing.
But it's a large gun.
It's a small gun.
What people want to know is why have you had a gun tattooed to your body?
It's a water gun. Yeah. It shoots water.
It's not though, is it?
It is.
Eh?
It is.
So
it's got no end on it.
Why have you had that done? Why have you had a gun?
Just because I like the way it looks. I wanted to get it tattooed to me.
Who smells the worst? This is at Radical Ashton of the band.
Continuing. Are you bringing this on yourself or what?
No, mate. I'm just continuing the fact that you told the world I stink. Yeah. I'm returning the favour.
Okay.
Which is the who really stinks the worst?
I've been told that you stink the worst.
You're not even in the band.
All right, let's go to one from
Alan. We smell quite good, actually.
You don't smell too bad. Alejandra here. What's the weirdest thing a girl has done to impress you?
The weirdest thing? What's the weirdest thing a girl's done to impress us, boys? Help me out here.
Niall, come on. You know I'm good at this kind of thing.
What's that?
Weirdest thing.
Yeah, you know I'm good.
The weirdest thing a girl has done to impress you?
Tweet Piers Morgan.
Yeah. Hitting a
pin. You stink.
Boys, we're going to have to drop this joke eventually because it really isn't funny.
Yeah, it's not funny. And also, as now you've met me in the flesh, it's not true, as you know.
No, it's you do stink.
Final question for you, Zane. This is a Google Plus question.
Yeah.
From a guy called Ted. Who cries the most?
Out of us five?
Yes.
Niall's quite teary.
Oh, Oh, you're cheerful now.
And Liam likes a good cry as well.
He does?
Yeah.
Coming to Louis, you're looking a bit vulnerable over here, mate. You've been talking a big game.
Yeah.
What is the one rumour that you never want to hear about yourself?
That I'm not very good at football.
Are you any good at football?
Not really.
So you would hate to have that confirmed?
Yes, which I've just done now to plenty of people.
What is the worst thing you've ever had to read about yourself?
I don't know about myself, but I've read a few of the boys have been dead, and that wasn't pleasant to read, to be honest with you. Liam, you died once, didn't you?
I've died a few times. Yeah. I don't know what people got a vendetta.
Mm. I mean, I've seen you all dying on stage a few times, but that's different, right?
Oh, yeah. I've come a rack up on stage a few times, definitely.
Yeah, mate.
A lot of people are asking, do you guys really enjoy the fame? Or does it become, after a while, a bit suffocating?
Well, I think there are days that it can feel like that, but, you know, if you are having one of those days, it's just made so much better when you go off at the end of the day and walk out into the concert and see all those fans there. And it really does just make you think, this is where it is.
Definitely does.
A guy called FCRRC was the Twitter address. Who has had the most girlfriends in your entire lifetimes?
Define girlfriends.
You define girlfriends.
Fair enough.
Any help, boys? Who do you think's had the most girlfriends in the
world? I'll tell you what, let's make it easier. Definitely. Let's ask each of you.
I often drift in and out
right,
relationships.
Zane, how many girlfriends you have in your life?
I'd say my current relationship is my only proper girlfriend.
Really?
Yeah.
One girlfriend?
You count, yeah. Like when you're at like primary school. Right?
If that's the case, yeah, I've had a lot of girlfriends.
Primary school's a bit weird, isn't it?
Well, come on, Harry, you must have had more than one girlfriend.
I mean, like, you know when you like hold hands with someone when you're like, hey, is that your girlfriend or not?
How many girls have you kissed in your life?
Like, eight.
Eight?
Yeah.
All right, we have a new winner.
I'm going to say...
No?
Maybe three.
Eight.
Three?
Are you sure?
Three
now?
Or four, yeah.
Liam?
One in the 30s, aren't you,
now? I'm going to say maybe five or six.
Five or six. So, there's not many to beat. Eight.
No, I think I'd probably say... only one proper relationship. Yeah. Really. Probably two.
You're trying to convince me, you lot, you've only kissed about 20 girls between you.
We're very busy, you know.
We have a lot of things to do in the day.
But you're pop stars.
How many, people have you kissed, Piers?
More than 20.
Oh,
you naughty boy.
So I've now...
You naughty boy.
My daughter needs to know that I am more popular with women than the entire One Direction band. That's what
you
she needs to know.
Naughty boy.
Okay, here, what about this one? This is from Biden Daniel. What is the most embarrassing thing you've caught one of the other band members doing?
We're live, remember?
Yeah.
We're live.
That's a good question. Anyone got anything clean? Anyone?
He knows.
No,
go on. You know.
No, I don't know.
Yeah, you do. You're thinking of something right now.
I don't.
Come on, Harry Styles.
I haven't.
You've witnessed something horrific with one of these. Come on. What was it? What was it and when was it? You can't even look. He's pointing at him. What was it?
There's nothing. It was, no big deal.
OK, well, let's go back then to Liam. You've been waiting very patiently.
How's it going there, Stinky?
Very well, thanks, Smilly. Let's see if I haven't been looking. OK, this is from another fan, Moore. Why do you always look so sexy? Oh, hang on. Oh. Sorry, that was to me. I'm sorry. No, that was for you. Why do you always look so sexy?
I don't know.
See, now he's doing the sexy eyes.
It's not a great question, is it?
It's rubbish.
Okay, this one's quite good. Why do you all wear skinny jeans? And does it make your voices really high and squeaky? And can we test the theory by making you all make the highest sound with your voices that you can?
Right, I think we can all agree the tightest jeans in the room are on Mr. Harold Styles.
Yeah, he loves a good pair of tight jeans.
He loves a pair of tight
How
jeans.
How high can you squeak?
You squeak pretty high. Yeah.
Well, go on, give it a full.
Well, like a.
Yeah.
Not one of them.
Okay, can you be that? Yep. That might be one of the worst pieces of television I've ever been involved with.
Yeah.
I just want to say that. Look, guys, thank you very much. We have millions of people writing in. I think it's an amazing event you're putting on today. I actually love the a cappella. I've become a One Direction fan.
You always were.
But in return, you've got to stop calling me small.